Value is a difficult thing to gauge in the NBA. Look at how much debate there is surrounding the MVP award. These players aren't MVP candidates, some are far from it, but they are having underrated seasons. It's time they get some love. Here's the 13-man active roster for the NBA's 2016-17 all-underrated team. Starters. Dewayne Dedmon, center, Spurs. Where did this guy come from? Oh, Orlando, that makes a lot more sense now. Dedmon was a revelation this season for the Spurs, playing their first year without the legendary Tim Duncan. Though Dedmon isn't one of the greatest big men of all time, like his predecessor, he is one of the best rebounders in the league, 30% defensive rebound rate, and has posted a defensive rating of 97.2 on 65.2 true shooting. James Johnson, power forward, Heat. Johnson gave Miami a little bit of everything, just when they needed it. After the Heat's poor start to the season, Johnson began getting more run and the Heat thrived. Since the All-Star game, Johnson is averaging 14.2 points, 4.8 rebounds, and 4.2 assists a game with a +7 net rating. Otto Porter, small forward, Wizards. Porter is having a career year in the final season of his rookie contract, so much so that the consensus around the league is that the Georgetown product will receive a max offer sheet this summer. A max offer sheet for Otto Porter? It makes a lot of sense when you consider that he's developed into a dead-eye shooter this season. Porter has an effective field goal percentage of 60, better than Kevin Durant, and a blistering offensive rating of 110. Avery Bradley, SG, Celtics. Everything Celtics fans think Marcus Smart is or will become, Bradley already is. A tenacious competitor, Bradley plays with defensive energy that doesn't show up in the box score, but it does set the tone for Boston. He's willing to check anyone on the court and almost always holds his own. He also is averaging 16.4 points on 46/39/73 shooting, grabbing 6.1 rebounds per game at 6'2" and averaging a steal a game. Mike Conley, PG, Grizzlies. Conley might not be underpaid, but his reputation is not befitting the player he is. This is one smooth operator. In 2016-17 he improved his scoring average by 5.3 points, pushed his three-point shooting over the 40% threshold, dished out assists at his best rate since 2012, was still a great on-ball defender at his position and seemingly improved as the year progressed. Bench. Joe Ingles, SF, Jazz. Ingles, a career 36% three-point shooter, is third in the NBA in three-point shooting this season at 44%. He's also a secondary playmaker for one of the most joyful offenses in the NBA, often operating off the elbow, and a solid defender, 1.2 steals per game, capable of checking four positions. Who would have predicted that Ingles would have an offensive rating of 109.6 this season? Danilo Gallinari, SF, Nuggets. Few players have benefited from the pace and space revolution more than Gallinari, who extended his strong form from last season into this one, setting new highs in field goal and three-point shooting. In all, he is averaging 18.2 points and 5.2 rebounds per game. And get this, he was actually a league average defender this year as well. Sean Livingston, G, Warriors. Few players are able to control the pace of a game like Livingston, whose contributions to the Warriors remain nearly immeasurable. Livingston's box score numbers are down this year, but he played plenty of critical minutes because of his defensive length and court vision, and he's always had a 12-foot turnaround jumper, a shot I'm not sure he's ever missed, when needed. Enes Kanter, C, Thunder. The man does not play lick of defense. Not a lick. But that's not his role, his job is to score, and few players in the league are more prolific at that than Kanter, who has averaged 14.4 points in 21.4 minutes per game this season. Kanter also had one of the best offensive rebound percentages in the NBA. Goran Dragic, PG, Heat. You can point to several things that helped facilitate Miami's turnaround, but one of them has to be Dragic's move to score more and pass less. Normally, that'd seem like a recipe for disaster, but Dragic has perfectly balanced the need to be more aggressive in finding his shot and facilitating the offense. He got red hot in January and February, shooting well above 40% from beyond the arc and better than 50% from the floor overall. In all, his 20.2 points per game is his best mark since his great 2013-14 season with Phoenix. Clint Capela, see, Rockets. The Rockets didn't have to give Dwight Howard the max contract, they could have resigned him to a fair value deal. Instead, they opted to lean on Capela as the team's starting center. It was a great decision. Capela is averaging a career-high 12.4 points per game, pulling down 8.1 rebounds and providing much-needed interior defense. Gary Harris, SG, Nuggets. His shooting has gone above 50%. His three-point shooting has gone above 40, and he has been absolutely lethal on the catch and shoot, 66% EFG. This might not have been a breakout year, but Harris has told the league that it better watch out. Skalabis year, PF, Kings. Before DeMarcus Cousins was traded, Skal was a frequent sitter, playing in only 7 games. It was easy to write him off as a rookie bust. But since that Boogie trade, he's been on the court, and he's been awesome. He's played 23 games, starting 10, averaging 21 minutes a night. In that time he's averaging 11 points and 6 rebounds per game on 55% shooting. In all, it makes his sophomore campaign one of the most intriguing in the league and has landed him the last spot on this roster.